Thank you. I am Pau Oliva. I am a mobile security engineer with viaForensics. And today I will be giving a high-level introduction to reverse engineering Android applications. First, we will see how is an Android application, like from the file that compounds it. Then we will see a few methods to obtain the Android application either from a mobile device or from the Android market. Then we will see a few methods to reverse engineering the application and change its behavior. And finally, we will see a quick demo using Santoku Linux, which is a Linux distribution that has all the tools needed to do this real quick, so you don't need to set up your computer. First, an Android application is just a zip file, a simple zip file, renamed to APK extension. It contains the application resources, which are media files or images that the application might need to display. It also contains the Android manifest, which is an XML file. In a final APK, this file is binary, but when developing the application, it's just a simple text file, which contains, for example, the permissions that the application will use, and the application name, the first activity that will be launched when the application is executed. Then it contains a cryptographic signature in the meta-inf folder. And finally, it contains the classes.dex file, which is where all the binary bytecode of the application is compiled, and it's what the Dalvik virtual machine will execute. The Dalvik virtual machine is similar to the Java virtual machine on a computer, but on Android devices. So now that we know what an Android APK is, we need to get the APK of the application that we want to reverse engineer. So easiest way is if you have the application installed on your device, you just can get any application to back up apps to SD card, for example, APK Optic or Astro File Manager. There are a lot of applications that do this. So you just back up it on your SD card and you get the APK. Another way is using the Android Debug Bridge. If you go into developer settings on your phone and enable ADB debugging, then you can use the command line tool ADB, which comes with the Android SDK, to communicate with the phone. So with the command PM list packages, you see a list of all the applications that are installed on your phone. And then you just need to pull the application, which will be on the data app directory of the phone. So you just put the package name and then .apk at the end, and you will pull the application from the phone itself. If you don't have a phone, or if you don't have the application installed on your phone, you can also download the application directly from the Android market. There is an unofficial Google Play APA, which is written in Python. You just have to edit the config file and provide Google account credentials and an Android device ID, and then you are able to download from command line just using this unofficial Google Play API. You can search on Google Play, you can download application, and it's very handy. Also, you can use a browser extension or a web service like APK Downloader. It's very simple. You just put the package name or the Google Play URL, and it generates the download link, so you can directly download the APK file from Google Play. Once we get the APK file, we can disassemble it. Disassembling is to convert the DEX file, the Dalvik executable file, into some form of assembly language, readable and text file, not binary file like DEX. So for this, There is a tool, Smally, Bug Smally, but this tool, APK tool, bundles it. So it's a multi-platform, it's written in Java, and it's open source, and it allows to transform the Dalvik bytecode into Smally source, into readable Smally source. And it allows also to change the contents of this Smally code, or also the resources, and then repackage back into an APK, so we can modify the application really easy. This is how the Smally source code looks like. You can see if the application is not obfuscated in any way, you can see the class name, method name, variable name, everything is in there. So, and also the calls to the standard Android APIs. But for some people, Smally is a bit difficult, so we can, instead of disassembling, we can decompile. The act of decompiling is to get the source code very similar to the original source code that the original author of the application wrote. To do this, we have a lot of Java decompilers available because Java is like a lot older than Android. So we can just transform the DEX file, which is the Android virtual machine bytecode, into Java bytecode, into a Java archive. And then we can use any existing Java decompiler. To do this, we use the DEX2JAR utility, which is also open source and multi-platform. It just converts DEX files into JAR files so that we can use any Java decompiler. A few examples here, like JDGuy, which is also multi-platform and with a nice user interface. There is JAT, which is a command line tool, and there are others. My favorite here is Procyon. It's written in Python, and it's a new one, so it's quite useful. But when we transform from DEX to JAR, we lose some metadata information present in the DEX file. So it's always better to use a decompiler which has been written with Android in mind. So it can read this data present in DEX files. So it can do DEX to Java directly without, to Java source, without going through the JAR process, which lose this important metadata. Unfortunately, there are not as many decompilers available. Actually, I only know two. The one is open source, is the one present in AndroGuard. The name is DAT. And the other one is commercial. The name is JEP. And it's the most used amongst professional reverse engineering. It's pretty good if you have to reverse applications that have been obfuscated in some way. Otherwise, the AndroGuard DAT is pretty cool for pretty much everything, but the other one is, helps you with some data structures and difficult obfuscations. I will now show you a quick demo. It's using Santoku Linux. You can download it here in santoku-linux.com. This is a Linux distribution which has a lot of open source tools pre-installed and ready to use. It has tools for doing mobile forensics, malware analysis, and mobile application assessment. So it covers pretty much anything. Here in the demo, we have in the left side, we can see the Android phone. And I'm using a Hello World application just for the demo purposes. I install it using the ADB install. Now we launch the application, and you can see that this is just a Hello Android application. So what we will do is change the string Hello Android to say Goodbye Android. We use DEX2JAR to convert the APK into a JAR file, and now JDGuy, which is the decompiler, to show the source code, the decompiled source code of the application. We see here that the string hello Android is present in the source code, in the decompiled source code. So we now use APK tool to decode the APK. It will create a folder with all the application resources and Smalley files. And in here we have the Hello Android class, which we will edit now. And we will look for the Hello Android string in this Smalley file, so we can change it and then recompile the application, the modified application, with our change on it. So we put just goodbye instead of hello. Now we use APK tool again to build the modified APK. Now we have to sign the application with char signer, the modified one. Now we uninstall the application which is installed on the phone, and we install our modified one. We do this using the ADB command line tool. So after installing it, we'll launch it, and you will see that now it says goodbye Android instead of hello Android. This is a silly change just for demo purposes, but you can do this to change the behavior of any Android application. Like, for example, if you want to cheat in a game and have infinite life, or if you want, have paid features on a free app or things like that. So in summary, we have learned that Android package files are just zip files, simple zip files. APK tool is very handy to extract the binary resource, and also allows us to modify and repackage APK files. Dex2jar is useful to convert Dalvik bytecode to Java bytecode, and then we can use any Java decompiler to obtain the compiled source code. But pure Android decompilers are better because they don't lose the metadata information present on DEX files. And finally, Santoku Linux has all the tools that you need to reverse engineer Android application. Also, my colleagues Andrew and Sebas will be doing a talk on Santoku Linux. They will show you a few more things, more advanced things that you can do. They will reverse a malware piece. So if you want to see it, it's at 10:40, I guess, on room 3022. And that's it. Here's my contact information. So if you have any comments, just ping me on Twitter or send me an email. And thank you very much for attending.